Dear students, I welcome you all to your educational channel Learn and Educate. In the past few videos, we have studied up till section 27. Now let us continue with the law series Code of Civil Procedure 1908, section 28. Section 28 is service of summons when a defendant resides in another state. Subsection 1. A summons is issued for report in another state to such a court and in such manner as may be prescribed by the rules in force in that state. This says that a summons will be issued in another state to the court residing in another state. Then the summons will be issued in such a manner as prescribed by the rules in that particular state to where the summons is being sent. Subsection 2 says that the court where a summons is sent shall, upon receipt of it, proceed as if it has been issued by such court and shall return the summons to the court to the issuing court together with the record of proceedings, if any, with respect to that. This deals with the duty to the court where the summons is sent. The court where the summons is sent shall determine the proceedings and return it to the issuing court with regard thereto. Section 28, Subsection 3 states that about the languages of the summons. Subsection 3 states that where the language of summons sent for service in another state is different from the language of record, as mentioned in Subsection 2, a translation of the record shall be made and as per Clause A in Hindi, where the language of court issuing the summons is in Hindi, where the language of the issuing court is in Hindi, then the record shall be in Hindi. And Subsection 3, Clause B states that the translation of the record shall be in Hindi or in English, where the language of such a record is other than Hindi or English, then shall be sent together with the record sent under the subsection 3. This states that where the language, the translation of the record will be in Hindi, where the language of the court, issuing court, the summons is Hindi, and a translation shall be made of the record in English or either in Hindi, where the language of such a record is other than Hindi or English, shall also be sent together with the record sent under subsection 3. For example, in any state where Hindi or English is not the language, the issuing court's language in that state is not Hindi or English, then a translation shall be made along with the record sent under subsection 3. Section 28 deals with the service of summons or defendant resides in another state. It deals with that shall be sent to that particular state as per the rules prescribed or enforced in that particular state. The state which has received such summons shall issue return the summons along with the proceedings, if any, as if it was issued by such court, and the language of the summonses. Section 29 deals with service of foreign summons. A, Clause A, any civil or revenue court established in any part of India to which the provisions of this made summons or other process is issued by any civil court or revenue court established in any part of the India to which the provisions of this court do not extend, or Clause B, any civil or revenue court established or continued by the authority of the central government outside India. First of all, the court or civil court or revenue court which is established in any part of the India but the provisions of CPC 1908 does not apply to that, or any civil or revenue court established or continued by the authority of central government outside the India. Clause C states about Section 29, Clause C states about any other civil or revenue court outside India to which the central government has by notification in the official gazette declared that the provisions of this section shall apply, must send to the courts in the territory to which this court extends and served as if they were the summons issued by such court. What has happened? And if any code, revenue code established in the any part of the India to which this code does not extend, any code or any civil code or revenue code established or continued by the authority or the central government which is outside India, or any code or any civil or revenue code outside India to which the central government has, by the notification of the official gazette, applied the provisions of this section 29 has applied, it may send to the court in the territory to which this code extends. The court will send the summons to that court in which, to the court in the territories to which this code of CPC applies, and serve as if it were issued by such courts, and serve the summons as if it were issued by such courts. Section 30 deals with power of order, discovery, and the like. Subject to conditions, the limitations as may be prescribed, the court may at any time, either of its own motion or on an application of any party, A, make such orders as may be necessary or reasonable in all the matters relating to the delivery and answering of the interrogations, the admissions of documents and facts, the discovery, inspection, production, impounding, and the return of documents or other material objects producible as evidence. Subject to the conditions and limitations which is prescribed by the court at any point of time, either of its motion or in an application made by the other party. A. It makes an order which is necessary and reasonable in all the matters relating to the delivery and answering of the interrogations between the parties, the admission of the documents and facts, the discovery, inspection, production and impounding, return of the documents or other material objects producible as evidence. Section 13 is continued. B. Issue summons to persons whose attendance is required either to give evidence or to produce documents or such other objects as are aforesaid. Issue summons to the persons to give evidences, to give attendance about the evidences, either to give evidence or produce documents related to such other objects. C. Order any facts to be proved by the affidavit. It may order the facts to be proved using the affidavit. Section till we are successor in section 28 is deal with the issue of summons where the defendant resides in another state, issue of service, issue of foreign summons, and power to order discovery and the like.